Vice-Chancellor of the University of the West Indies and Chairman of the CARICOM Reparations Commission, Professor Sir Hilary Beckles, lamented the tragic nature of the slave trade as it relates to the exploitation of the slaves, which generated tremendous wealth for the exploiters. He says poverty, consistent racism, and underdevelopment are all living reminders of that dark era. In 2013, a CARICOM Reparations Commission was set up to seek redress for all these grievances.
What you're talking about is the unraveling of modernity, the crumbling of the structures that supported modernity, the white supremacy, the racism, the colonization, the
imperialism,
all of that is breaking down to create a new frontier for the 21st century.
But can you lay all of that to the slave legacy, you know, discriminatory policing practices?
That's the core of it. I mean,
really?
What happened in India with the destruction of the Indian 19th century industrial economy by Britain? What is happening all over Africa? What happened to the indigenous people of the New World? All of this is part of the same conversation.
On Sunday, August 1st, St. Lucia joined other former British colonies in celebrating Emancipation Day. On August 1st, 1834, slavery in the British Empire came to an end.
Emancipation is here again. Sunday, 1st August, is celebrated as Emancipation Day. Some will say it's the 187th anniversary, and some may say it is the 183rd anniversary, depending on whether one is calculating from the Abolition Act of 1834 or 1838. Nonetheless, the occasion is really what we must focus on. Emancipation is dear to the heart of black people all over the world. It is well accepted all over the world that unless the rights of the least of men are as assiduously protected as those of the greatest, then the seeds of confidence in human rights and human dignity will fall on barren soil. All men must stand equal under the law as they are in the eyes of the Creator. Our ancestors upon whose shoulders we stand today, fought a bitter struggle in order that we can enjoy some of the rights and freedoms and businesses we have today.
The Caribbean community has been appealing for the payment of what it deems a debt owed by former colonizers for over 200 years of free labor. Labor that helped countries in Europe to flourish while leaving the nations of the Caribbean largely underdeveloped and poor. For the DBS News World, I'm Don Nicholas.